If you want to go fast on a budget, these affordable sports cars are a great alternative to your dream supercar. Well, you might not get an insane power and speed of Ferraris and Lamborghinis, but these cheap supercar lookalikes still offer plenty of style and performance. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe to this video.
What the heck?
No, subscribe to the channel so I get to make more videos like this for you. Now, the cheapest supercar alternative in the world and the fastest is the company car. No, just kidding. But pretty darn good choice is a Lotus Elise, and that is the first car on our list today. You can get one starting from 15,000 and they go up towards 30 or 40,000 or even more depending on the version and condition of the car. And it is considered to be one of the best handling cars in the universe. Maybe that's an exaggeration too, but they do handle very, very well. And in the Elise too, you get an underrated but incredible 2ZZ engine from Toyota. Matter of fact, the engine was so good that Lotus asked Toyota if they can use that engine in their car, and they rev up to 8000 RPM and sound just beautiful. Just listen to this. Two on the list is the car that Jesse from Fast and Furious 1 lost the race to.
You visualize the win. Hey, visualize the win, Jesse.
Jesse, don't do it. I bet you he's got more than 100 grand under the hood of that car.
And I'm talking about the roadster Honda S2000. The name derives from its high-revving 2-liter engine, and also as a kind of name tribute to the old versions S500, 600 and S800 Hondas. You can find one starting at 10,000 euro or dollars, at least in the year 2024 when I recorded this video. It also drives very well. It sounds amazing. It revs up to 9,000 RPM. The car is moddable, there's plenty of aftermarket support, and it looks beautiful, even in 2024. Next car on the list is a rotary toy that kind of scares away people because of its engine, but needlessly. The Mazda RX8 is one of the best handling cars I've ever driven, and is certainly one of the best handling cars you can get for that amount of money. Drives like a bigger go-kart. The engine is an engineering marvel. If you find a well-kept, well-starting example, run some chainsaw oil in it to prolong the life of the engine. It will serve you well. The engine sounds great, it revs to the moon, you can modify it, you can bridge port it, you can get all this done to get your wraps in, and it has over 230 horsepower from the 1.3 liter version. The high power one, so it's an incredible machine, and it sounds good. For the next car on the list, we are going to the land of beer and pretzels, because I'm talking about Audi TT. Remember when in school there was always this somebody who always wanted to be the best at everything? And sometimes they were the best at some things. Give them that. That's Audi TT. First gen was really good with the engines. Not the greatest handling one. The second gen had a good handling, but looked kind of dull. Nevertheless, great cars with crisp ride quality and snappy engines. The first generation with a brilliant 1.8 turbo petrol engine will set you back around 4K. For the newer example with the VR6 engine, the one you can find in Golf as well, you'll need to pay around, what is it, 20,000, yeah. But oh boy, is it worth it. Thank you. The next car here is a result of what people were saying about American cars, that they don't handle well. That was true. So, with a bold claim, Chevrolet came out with a Corvette C4 and claimed that it could generate 0.95 G of forces while cornering. Mind you, at that time, even Porsches couldn't get to 0.9 G, so that was a huge thing to say. And it was, and it's still in fact, very well handling car even by today's standards. The early versions were a little bit slower, but over the years the C4 improved and gotten really well at the end of the production. It was faster, better handling, and just better quality car in general. You can expect to find them around 10 grand mark, and they sound good. Next thing, I can't do this list without mentioning or without listing the BMW Z3 or Z3 M. And if you can get your hands on the 2001 model with the big engine from E46 M, you'll be the luckiest man alive. Because BMW went just nuts with installing 315 horsepower into a body that looks like a Miata. It is scary fast. You know, Miata is just easy to drive, easy to handle, it doesn't kick back. With BMW, with this big of an engine, it will kick you back. That will come at a price of 35,000 plus for M example. Expect to pay more if the car is really good condition, but for around 10 grand you can get a regular Z3 depending on the condition and engine as well. On the list is the car that wasn't supposed to be here. But to be completely honest with you, I suddenly remembered about the company during writing the previous section, which was about the BMW Z3M. And I'm talking about the new Caterham 620R. Is that how you say Caterham? Caterham? Caterham. Caterham. Something. Anyway, back to the car. This car is just insane. It has 310 horsepower in a just a little bit over 500 kilogram body. That's over 600 horsepower per ton. With this calculation, you get 2.79 seconds 0 to 100 or 0 to 60. This is just nuts. So what Caterham did, they took the already fast 2.0 Duratec engine from the, was it 420? And slapped a supercharger on it. It's not a car, you're basically strapped to a missile that shoves flies into your teeth. And for a price mark of over 50,000, it could be yours. Is it worth it? That's it for today, thanks for watching. If you want, you can join the Discord channel for sending stupid memes, link is in the description. Nobody's watching the end of videos anyway, so I can put anything I want in there.